Believe it's recording, okay. And now, generally, I like to start from this position today to see. It's white to move. What you play for white? Kind of, you can take your time. So, guys, when you're here, let me know. So far, only Eric is here. So Eric, it's white to move, yeah? Oh, sorry, not this position. Black just played knight d5. Wait, white cannot move? Black just played this move. And now it's white to move. What do you play for white? That's my question. Eric, last time you sent me a game, yes? Eric,
What?
you sent me a game by Skype last time against Ender Tank?
No.
Ah, that is not you. That is. Ah, last time we miss you. Okay, you was missing last time the lesson, yes?
Yeah.
Okay, got it now. Okay, nice to meet you then. I told Benjamin miss last time, but that was basically you. And you checked the lesson by video? You saw the lesson?
Yeah.
Okay, and you learned something or
Yeah.
no? Okay. Happy to hear that. Okay, now I changed a little bit. Last time I was just explaining for beginning and was relatively easy to get decision because you knew the topic and kind of the ideas was more easy to find. But today's topic is basically how the GM's taking decisions. So in every type of position we take decision because of different situations. So it will be much more difficult today and complicated than the previous time. Okay, it's white to move here, let's say. Yes, how I mentioned. Are the other guys already here?
Yep.
Hello, boys, you there or no? So far, only Eric is here. At least I know about him.
I'm here.
Who is there?
Ben.
Okay, Ben, good to see you. And what about Justin and Andrew? Are they here?
I'm here.
And you are Andrew?
Yeah.
Okay, and your friend Justin is here or no?
Here.
Okay, good. So today topic I mentioned already, it's how GMs take decision. That's mean every type of position we take different decision, yeah? For example, last lesson was pair of bishop. So when we have position of pair of bishop, we takes decision because of that advantage. Today we'll have many different type of position, so I will try to show different. But now I like to start with this position, just to see it's a sharp position with opposite side castle. Black just played knight d5, and my question, I will give you a few minutes. Let's say 3 5 minutes to see what you will play. When you are ready with your move, you can just text me your move by Skype. Justin is very fast, huh? Okay, let me check. I can see here to let everybody think. And Benjamin, you sent me one game, yes, last time. Okay. We can go very quickly. Yes, type here, please. Like that. The other cannot see the answer. Justin, I cannot understand which move you like to play for black. For white, sorry. Black just played knight d5.
I accidentally did it. I accidentally said that on purpose. I mean, on accident.
Okay. Okay, Ben, you are right. I believe you saw in some book, yeah? Okay, I know about which book you're talking. Okay, good. Bravo. It's a very famous book from a very famous author. Let's give a few more minutes for the others. Okay, guys, I can give you some tip. It's opposite side castle. In this type of position, most important it's to attack first, kind of. That's why you should think how to attack. If you can exploit some attacking rules, that could help you. I will not let you know attacking rules. Eventually, later in the lesson, I will give you attacking rules. What you are doing during the attack number one, number two, number three. Kind of like that. What about Eric? Because that is difficult. Eric, do you have some idea or not yet? Eric? If you don't have idea, I'm fine. I just, this is a position you can spend a lot of time and maybe you won't find even the solution. I'm just asking if you have solution. If not, I will continue with the lesson and eventually later we can come back about this. Justin and Andrew, do you have some idea about which move you told?
No.
And Eric, about which move? You spent your time. Which move you calculate? Or which moves?
I calculated knight takes e7, knight takes e7, h6.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay. Kind of, more or less what I expected. Everything is good. I will keep this. I like just to continue with the next one. Just to say, I told you today I will go. But before that, I like very briefly to go over the Benjamin sent me a game. Basically, the truth is there's nothing so much about this game. What I can suggest to Benjamin is to not play e6. That's not mistake, of course. Every move here, it's not mistake. But I think it's much easier for black to play if they just kind of copy white and trying to bring bishop out. That's what I suggest. Otherwise, later, black has problem to decide what to do with this bishop. Of course, that's its normal move. It's not mistake. I'm just telling you that bringing bishop out, it's keeping more easy for black to play. So far, everything normal. This is kind of the some theory. And now blacks like to trade the bishop from the other diagonal. Andrew considered to not play queen e2. I believe he's still on preparation. Ben, is this game in the junior championship in St. Louis?
No. It was during like the National Congress.
And when? Where is this tournament, National Congress?
Pennsylvania.
Somehow, position is familiar to me. I can't really remember. But, okay, time by time, I work with Andrew about, especially about London. So far, everything normal. And I know he had a game with a wonder like that. I remember a wonder tried this system. A wonder hold, but generally, this system, it's slowly for black. It's considered like good according theory, but it's more difficult to play for black than it's for white. What I suggest you is just to not play this system. And I told you, I suggest you just to go bishop out. It's much easier. This. Generally, I don't like this taking. I prefer white always in this pawn structure. I also played like that in the London when my opponent took my bishop. Maybe even he took with the knight, my bishop. Anyway, I let him to take. White has easy play with knight on e5 next. Okay, kind of everything normal. And now, let's stop here. We have a typical position where white like to play on the king side, exploiting the space advantage with the knight on e5 and switching some rook on the third rank. They also could push pawns if necessary, g3, h4, because they have more pawns. Black should try to open some file and to get some counterplay on the queen side. But how I mentioned, it's much easier to play for white. This knight looks a little bit unplaced because most likely black going to open this file, and it's easy to see knight is very bad on the open file eventually. Okay, that's good decision. Knight was bad placed, so you like to improve. So far everything normal. And white makes some pressure. That move makes sense because it's going to fight for an open file. And kind of you blunder something here, yeah? But the truth position looks difficult for black. Somehow white has more space and looks more active, and black are mainly defending. This move looks ugly. I didn't calculate, but kind of because you also give the opponent some tempi. And generally, this move doesn't make sense because you don't like to play this move to trade queen because always some checks, like ideas. Understand, yeah? I don't really understand the idea of this move, to be honest, except that you're wasting time. I don't know what you calculated, but to be honest, I really don't have the ideas about this move, and according to you, that it's some blunder. You mentioned that you stopped to calculate something after this move. But this looks more obvious move, at least. I believe he has to take the pawn. Because I'm pretty sure he's not going to take the pawn. If I'm white, I will, because pawn is stuck, most likely I will just improve my pieces and I will take the pawn when I want, not when you want. Usually it's going like that. In the game, you consider such a move or no?
I thought if he didn't take the pawn, I could put like queen a8 and rook f6.
But anyway, you are stuck. If I just bring my pawn to b5, that it's more than I want. With such a knight on c6, I don't need to take this pawn. You are completely stuck, and next I could easy go. What is my main idea? Attacking on the king side. It's easy to see you completely squeeze it. Is that clear?
Like b5 instead of rook f6?
Yes, you could try. Yes, but still I could go a4 b5 eventually. Still looks eventually promising. I just like to show what I will try to squeeze it to. Anyway, I believe you blunder, but how I mentioned, this for me looks like mistake. I will tell you why. It's usually how GMs take decision because it's giving you some counterplay. And usually we like to avoid this. Let's see, engine is usually greedy. Usually try to avoid to give opponents counterplay. I'm surprised that engine think position is completely equal when it looks very tough for you. But okay, that move doesn't make sense because only g3. He likes to attack on the king side. Maybe knight f4, queen check, some tactics maybe he found. Okay, but let's say that it's kind of more human, just to see. Look, see what I wanted before, just to see. He'll like some tactical ideas, okay. Because this has to be losing position. usually we don't calculate, we just evaluate. You are very stuck. That's how GMs take decision. Usually engines doesn't understand that's the difference between humans and engines. But I told you, I believe that generally it's more difficult for you to play this offering. That's your main point. Here, you're just wasting camp I and you need this being this 97 check and then yeah, you are losing. But generally, probably you have to delay with taking from d4 because how you see, he's faster. Usually, guys, we make such a moves when we are sure we're going to win the open files. Because look, you have more space, you can double your rooks on the open file and eventually later take. Is that clear? I believe your main mistake is taking. Usually don't take first, guys, remember this. If you can make useful move, keep tension and never take first. So just go rook c8 or knight d6, what was your idea, knight d6. Follow your ideas. If he goes rook c1, why you have to take top on his rook? Is that clear?
Yeah.
You can play some useful. Maybe you never will open this one. You go c4 and then b5, b4. I think this was the main mistake. Now it's more easy for him because he played rook c1 and queen a6, very obvious move. Yeah. And then you get some problems here because knight is going to c6. Okay, let's now see games going to the lesson. But mainly what you should learn from this game, never take first, keep tension and improve your pieces. Taking first is making opponent's game easier, opponents. Because otherwise he never know you're going to take or no. Maybe you're going to close the center, understand, yeah? Don't make opponent's life easier. Okay, now I have here, I want to go from this position. Here, they agreed draw. Because blacks like to take, kind of game was like that. This, 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 and they agreed draw. Understand, yeah? Is this clear, guys? But white missed one good idea to get advantage. Of course, I was watching the game online. Surprisingly, Jeffrey had short of time. Maybe he has around 6-7 minutes till the end of the game. I mean, till the move 40. And his opponent has maybe like 45-50 minutes. And kind of he was short of time and he suck up all everything he did correct till here. Just here he accepted the draw, kind of. Okay, I will give you time to think, to see, can you find some good idea for white now? How white can fight for advantage? That's my question. When you get some idea, please text me. Okay, Justin, thank you. Let's wait for others. Okay, that's true. What about others? Okay. Okay, Ben, good, bravo. Eric, do you have some idea? Ben, do you know this from before? Ben, Benjamin. Okay. Eric, any idea? About which move you're thinking?
Takes B7.
Okay, and Andrew, you? Do you have idea or no? Andrew, you there?
Yeah.
About which move you're thinking?
Bishop F5.
And then I take your pawn? Okay, let's now go to other game, then we come back here to show you something. This game. Okay, this game we can go from the beginning very briefly. I don't know you know this game or not, that's a very famous game. So this is a typical idea in chess game. If you're an active player, you're not afraid to lose a pawn. Especially in the beginning of the game, if you're going to win two tempi, guys. Just to know, in chess game, two tempi for a pawn, it's okay. It's not a bad idea to suck. For sure, you have a compensation. If you can gain three tempi, that's always sacrifice. That means you're close to winning. Three tempi is really a lot. It's easy to see why two tempi. If you just take, we develop. Knight, he has to move queen away, and next we castle. Or making some other useful move, developing, and next maybe even move side castle. To get another tempi. He decided to refuse, doesn't matter. Again, he sucked the pawn. Of course, he can play bishop f3. But he's okay to gain two tempi. Most likely, he likes to attack in the future the king because black going to castle. Oh. And now again, we get kind of typical position. White has space advantage on the king side and all white pieces looks on the king side. So definitely white likes to attack on the king side. Looks how white are not wasting time. Blacks like to secure the knight, maybe afraid of b3 and c4. Yeah, later could come b3. And eventually c4. So they like to have maybe b4 to secure the good knight. But because black sooner or later has to play g6 and bishop f8, so white doesn't like to waste time going to this idea, h4, with idea h5, and then to sack to g6, because sooner or later black will play g6 to bring pieces to the fence. Finally, black decided to accept one of the white sacrifices, but like that, white are gaining tempi to open the h-file. How you can see now, we attack much faster because we gain it to tempi. We discussed this. Yes. He takes the bishop and he moves back. Like that, white already has open file and they play g3, king, g2 with tempo. Developing with tempo. And here I will go. Again, doesn't waste time attacking in the faster way. This is a calculation he cannot take. Bringing the other pieces with tempo, and black cannot bring any more pieces to defend. There, next checkmate with queen h7, queen takes the bishop, or queen h7, queen h8. So, how you see, he started one attack on the h-file. Later, how you see, few times this game, white suck a pawn, yes, like here, they suck a pawn to win two tempi. That is very typical. I suggest all my students to try to play like this, at least when they are young, to learn the dynamic way of the game, to play dynamically, to not be so much focused on material. If you are gaining too tempi, you should always sacrifice. Is that clear, guys? With three tempi, always sacrifice. With two, it's up to you. I usually suggest. And then you will figure out how to create the initiative. The time is important in the game. Okay, let's now come back to the other game to see basically what white miss. Something very similar like that. Yes, we have basically. I keep it open. So yes, basically, white missed this nice idea. Two of you mentioned, Andrew and Ben, mentioned bishop f5. Queen has to take, otherwise queen is trapped. You can go similar, yes. g4, g3, king, g2. So he takes the pawn. King f1, gaining a tempi. King has to go there only move, again g3. Basically, absolutely the same like of the Tal's game. And next, it's coming rook h1. And white getting a huge advantage. Black has to play knight e5, otherwise queen is trapped, and easy to see. White getting a huge advantage. So basically in the board game, we have similar idea to open the h-file with tempi. To gain a time to open the h-file like that, we can exploit the attack, the h7. Of course, after this game, I immediately showed that game of Jeffrey to have more ideas about that typical idea eventually. Okay, now let's go to another typical idea I like to show you. But first, I like to see kind of tactic, not so difficult tactic, to make the lesson more interesting. Here, we can go quickly from the opening. White played very interesting. Let's go. This is kind of mistake, just to know, probably the best move is this to really prevent e4, but then giving another weak square, maybe that's why knight f6 could be better than d5. G6 is a mistake because usually guys remember if opponent develop or you develop first the pieces next to the queen, not to the king, most likely you like to go for long side castle. For example, I just like to mention if d5, most likely bishop f4. Maybe we'll go again f3, e4, or h4 attack, but kind of we are ready to go alongside castle. So that's why white can start immediately to attack the typical attack against the fianchetto, because basically they like to castle on the alongside castle, on the queen side. Is that clear, guys? And kind of black like to keep the rooks. E4, white are playing very ambitious and correct. They discover all pieces. They're leading in development. So black cannot castle for a long now. And again, white develop first the pieces on the queen side. They are ready to castle. And easy to see, white has much more pieces into the battle. Nice tactical idea. The queen is untouchable because white easy win a material. Next takes the queen by check and win the bishop. Black are going for counter-attack, but black missed something. So, black are completely losing, guys. But just to have an idea, this move shouldn't work anyway, because tactic supports the strategy. So easy to see black are undeveloped, their king is much weaker than white, and they're going for tactics. That means there have to be some clue in their tactics. Is that clear? Remember this. Usually when we are the better side, when we have winning position, then we work for tactics. Looking for tactics. Tactics support the strategy to realize the advantage faster. Okay, let's go this check here. Can you find how white win now? How white win? Okay, Ben, thank you. You have eagle eye, huh? Ben, bravo. What about others? Let's ask Eric about which move you're thinking. Okay, correct. Bravo, Eric. You are right too. So Eric and Ben found a solution. Let's see Andrew and Justin. Guys, about which move you're thinking, Andrew and Justin. Just tell me which move you're thinking about.
I think you should play bishop b6.
Okay, and then after he takes, yes, that is the right move. We should look for forcing moves. He has to take, otherwise we just take queen.
Queen,
yeah.
Queen D, knight d1 maybe?
Yeah, knight d1 is the right idea. Now, guys, and next, either check. After he check this, and next we take the bishop by check and white win at this. Okay, very good, bravo. So, how you see, white made a good attack from the beginning. Black kind of underdeveloped. And usually tactics should not support when we're worse. So next, I like to go to this one. Wait, not this one. Leg one. Okay. Here, black made a mistake. Okay, but before two guys go to think about moves, let's evaluate the position. Whiter clear better, yes? Easy to see why, yes? White pieces are completely dominating them. Their black opponents. King looks active, even attacking something. A bishop is fantastic. Other bishops also attack. Rook also attack. All black pieces are defenders. So, my question is, how you will try to eventually realize your advantage? Try to move. Let's just see. Then I will give you some tips how to understand how we are taking decision. But let's first you let you think alone. Take like 2 minutes when you are ready with your ideas. Text me the move.